I know a true story. There used to be this camp about 60 miles from here, Camp Arawak. All these kids started getting killed. A bunch of little kids were hatcheted to death, and a girl got stabbed while taking a shower. One of the cooks got boiled in some water. The owner of the camp, he got it in his neck with an arrow.
Jesus.
About 30 people were killed, and the camp had to be closed down. The end.
Hello, Now Playing listeners. This is Arnie, and you want to go camping? Thanks to coronavirus and social distancing, I don't think too many camps are open, but Stuart Brock and I are going to sleepaway camp. That's right, because A Quiet Place has moved its release date, and we really don't know when that's going to come out, we asked our patrons and our supporters, what do you want us to do instead of A Quiet Place? And they picked sleepaway camp. So instead of two episodes of A Quiet Place and one episode of Bird Box, instead of three bonus reviews, now you're going to get five if you're a platinum level donor. Because there are five Sleepaway Camp movies, 1 through 4 and Return to Sleepaway Camp. Today we took our first hike in the woods with a review of the first 1983 cult classic Sleepaway Camp. Here's a clip from that show. And then I'll be back on the other side to talk to you about how you can hear the entire Sleepaway series.
Pshaw. I don't know. This is one you want on your resume. It's like Rocky Horror. Like, you just, Susan Sarandon is not embarrassed that she did a movie this tacky. And this opening, again, it just lets you know. This speedboat murder is hysterical. Like, yes, it is the same setup as Friday the 13th. Little Jason drowned because two camp counselors, well, they were fucking, but like, they were off doing something else. Here, it's going to be Marianne has to drive the speedboat, and Dolores has got to like scream while she water skis behind them.
Why doesn't Dolores just drop the rope? I mean, that's how you can come to a stop very quickly. She can just let go of the rope. But no, she's going to hang there and just shriek at these guys running the boat.
The best shriek I've ever heard. No exaggeration. She is the best horror movie shrieker I've ever heard. Truly awesome when she's like free-forming it. Just somebody tell the people fast! I don't think anyone ever speaks like that, but it's just she's awesome as they plow into this family on the sailboat.
And why did they linger on her so long afterwards? Like, after the whole thing happened, they have the guy in the side giving his blank look like, did I just see what happened? And the girls in the water just screaming and screaming and screaming. It's like an editor would have been helpful, but it was really strange they kept on her. Maybe because, Stuart, the people loved the scream as much as you did.
Yes.
But I felt it was really strange that they kind of lingered there. And they did a lot. They linger a lot on screaming in this movie during these kills. Strange.
Also unsettling.
But I want Dolores to comment on every movie. They should have brought her back for the commentary on the DVD. She's just in that scream, like just screaming everything that she's seeing. I'm gonna have a bagel! Awesome.
She'd have been better than the director on a commentary.
But also here in this next scene when Angela does come down the stairs, another big thing, and apparently I was wrong because I looked it up after the movie. I thought the mother, the Aunt Martha, was a guy in drag because of the way that the woman was playing this with her in this daffy, crazy, insane, I don't know what she was doing, soliloquies or the sign kind of stuff.
Oh no, I'm afraid that wouldn't do. That wouldn't do at all.
It's like her conscience is talking, but out loud. It's like, we can hear you, you know? And so with that characterization and the way she looked, and my apologies to the actress, I'm sorry, I thought she was fairly masculine. Her hands seemed like masculine, right? So I thought they were setting us all up for it the entire time. See?
Yeah, you know from the second you see that beret that, like, it's off. It's way off. And she's got to get the kids out of the house real quick because she's got to get to her Troll 2 audition. I mean, she is that good. I mean, she's that good. I'm, like, just, I'm so happy in these opening moments.
They also don't cheat because she makes a big deal. Here are your physicals, but don't tell anyone how you got them. Oh, no, that wouldn't be good. Not at all.
We will never spend enough time with Martha for my liking to know what has been going on for the 8 years that this cohabitation has been going on. But yes, Angela is being sent. How cruel is this? You know this woman's fucked up already. Oh, yeah, your dad was murdered at this Camp Aramac Lake? Well, why don't you go there with your cousin? It'll be fine. I mean, like, that in of itself is cruel. And the fact that she's clearly had no adjustment is, I think, mute all the time. It's hard to read because this is the only scene we have of her outside of the camp, but she seems to be a complete shell. And so they're just going to thrust this trauma victim back to the scene of the crime.
Neither Ricky nor Angela really talk much. Aunt Martha doesn't let you get a word in. She's having a conversation with invisible people at the moment. So she's yes. not going to let you get a word in edgewise. But given that 8 years have passed, I don't think when Angela is drawn out of her shell at camp, it's the first time she's spoken in 8 years. I think she lives a somewhat normal existence. They go to school, they do stuff, but she did not want to go to this camp, probably because her dad died in the lake, but also... Our spring-summer 2020 donation drive is coming to an end. So if you'd like to hear the Sleepaway series reviews, as well as our gold-level reviews of all the Tom Cruise movies of the 80s, where he was the star, plus Top Gun, and our silver-level reviews of the Candyman series and Jordan Peele's Us, head to nowplayingpodcast.com/donate. With a one-time pledge of $35 or more, you get access to 20 bonus reviews. Most of them are out now, but if you pledge before this donation drive is up, you're also going to get reviews of the new Candyman movie and the new Top Gun film, Maverick, when those are released. We expected them to be released during the donation drive. Corona made that impossible. But if you donate now, you'll get those reviews whenever the movies are made available. Our donation drive ends August 18th. A little bit earlier than we'd initially announced because of the change of dates of films. So if you donate by then, 20 bonus reviews, and know that every penny you donate goes to keeping Now Playing Podcast operating and improving the show every way we can. It's because of supporters we're able to do Totally Free Tuesday. And this Tuesday, we'll be back with a totally free review of Clear and Present Danger. We hope you'll join us for that. Thank you for listening to Now Playing. From all of the hosts and behind-the-scenes staff here, thank you for your support, and we'll be back soon.
Great. Thanks a lot. That was fun. Listen, you don't have AIDS or anything, do you?
No.
Great. See ya.
Your support helps keep Now Playing on the air.
Well, I hope you come back next year.
The opinions expressed on Now Playing are those of the individual hosts and may not reflect the opinion of Venganza Media Incorporated.
You know, I think I better take you over to your infirmary before your mouth gets you in any more trouble.
Venganza Media Incorporated is not affiliated with, and this podcast has not been prepared, approved, or licensed by any entity that created the film analyzed herein.
Keep your morals strong, and you'll never go wrong.
All movie clips and music included in this podcast are the intellectual property of the respective copyright holders. They are included here for the purpose of review, and no infringement is intended.
Don't tell anyone, okay? If the wrong person found out, I could lose an election someday.
Now Playing Podcast is an exclusive trademark of and may not be used without the expressed written permission of Venganza Media Incorporated.
You never can be too careful.
Now Playing is a Venganza Media production, copyright 2020, and no part of this show may be reproduced, repurposed, or redistributed without the written permission of Venganza Media Incorporated. All rights reserved.
Hey, Funk 19, time to go. Say goodnight and move out.